Good morning. Here in Wales, we have entered another lockdown, so sadly, we are unable to meet together in our churches. For next week's Remembrance Sunday, there will be a special online service from Llanelli, and on the 11th, there will also be a special pre-recorded ceremony of remembrance. Today in the church is Bible Sunday. Rana Khan will preach for us. Tracy Smith and Katie Tutt are our readers today. And Vaughan will share with us his music ministry. So let us now join together in worship. In this our church without walls. We have come together as a family of God in our Father's presence to offer him praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive his holy word, to bring before him the needs of the world. But first, because we have broken his laws and wounded his love, let us ask forgiveness for our sins and seek his grace that through his Son, Jesus Christ, we may give ourselves in service. Let us confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and merciful God, we have sinned against thee in thought and word and deed. We have not loved others with all our heart. We have not loved others as Christ loves us. We are truly sorry. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory and praise of your name. Amen.
May the Father of all mercies cleanse us from our sins and restore us in his image, to the praise and glory of his name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall show forth thy praise. We sing to you, O Lord, and bless your name, and tell of your salvation from day to day. Let us worship the Lord, all praise to his name. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Today's psalm is Psalm 119, verses 9 to 16. How can a young person stay on the path of purity by living according to your word? I seek you with all my heart. Do not let me stray from your commands. I have hidden your word in my heart, that I may not sin against you. Praise be to you, Lord. Teach me your decrees. With my lips I recount all the laws that come from your mouth. I rejoice in your following statutes. As one rejoices in great riches, I meditate on your precepts and consider your ways. I delight in your decrees and will not neglect your word. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Testament lesson is taken from Nehemiah chapter 8, verses 1 to 8. By the seventh month, the people of Israel were all settled in their towns. On the first day of that month, they all assembled in Jerusalem in the square just inside the water gate. They asked Ezra, the priest and scholar of the law, which the Lord had given Israel through Moses, to get the book of the law. So Ezra brought it to the place where the people had gathered, men, women, and the children who were old enough to understand. There in the square by the gate, he read the law to them from dawn until noon, and they all listened attentively. Ezra was standing on a wooden platform that had been built for the occasion. The following men stood at his right: Mattathiah, Shema, Ananiah, Uriah, Hilkiah, and Maaseiah, and the following stood at his left: Pedaiah, Mishael, Malkijah, Hashum, Hashbadanah, Zechariah, and Meshullam. As Ezra stood there on the platform, high above the people, they all kept their eyes fixed on him. As soon as he opened the book, they all stood up. Ezra said, "Praise the Lord, the great God." All the people raised their arms in the air and answered, "Amen, Amen." They knelt in worship with their faces to the ground. Then they rose and stood in their places, and the following Levites explained the law to them: Jeshua, Bani, Sherebiah, Jamin, Akub, Shabbathai, Hodiah, Maaseiah, Kelita, Azariah, Jozabad, Hanan, and Peliah. They gave an oral translation of God's law and explained it so that the people could understand it. This is the word of the Lord.
Matthew chapter 24, verses 30 to 35. Then will appear the sign of the Son of Man in heaven, and then all the peoples of the earth will mourn when they see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of the heavens to the other. Now learn this lesson from the fig tree. As soon as its twigs get tender and its leaves come out, you know that summer is near. Even so, when you see all these things, you know that it is near, right at the door. Truly I tell you, this generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. It is the Bible Sunday today, and later this week in the church calendar we will see we have another day to celebrate is the Reformation Day. The first edition of the Welsh Bible appeared in 1588 before the King James Bible, with a revised version published in 1620. It is this later version which continues to be used in Wales today. Many would credit Martin Luther as the driving engine that propelled the Reformation, but Martin Luther said, "I did nothing, the Word did everything." In fact, when most people attend an Anglican church, the first thing they notice is Bible, which has a central position in our worship. Every Sunday there are few readings that we listen. N.T. Wright, a great Anglican scholar and a former bishop, says, "The reading of scriptures in the Anglican tradition is most of its great glories. I was so moved to meet with one of my church wardens in the ministry area a couple of months ago when she told me that at the beginning of the lockdown, she started reading Bible. Now I think she might have finished, because 2 months ago she had arrived to the Gospel of Matthew. I'm going to tell you a story of three friends who decided to read Bible together. One was a doctor, another one was an engineer, and third one was a politician. So they finished a few chapters from the book of Genesis, and then they decided to reflect on the Word of God. The doctor said, "We read in the Bible that God took Adam's rib to create the woman. Definitely God must be a doctor. This looks like this is the oldest profession." The engineer said, "No, no. We read in the Bible there was a chaos and wild, and God created this beautiful earth out of chaos. He definitely must be an engineer to create such a beautiful world. That's why engineering is the oldest profession." The politician said, "No. Have you ever thought who created that chaos? God must be a politician." The events which we heard in our Old Testament reading, they happened when Jews came back from exile. When they were in Babylonia, they heard about Jerusalem, which was destroyed. And now they were rebuilding the temple in Jerusalem. A large wooden platform was made for Ezra, who joined by 13 men, 6 on his right side and 7 on his left side, to stand. The platform was elevated so that everyone can see as well as hear what they were going to read, the book of the law, word of God. Nehemiah, who was governor, and Ezra, the priest, the scribe, and the Levites, who taught the people, said to people, "This is the holy day to Yahweh our God. Don't mourn, don't weep, for God has given you satisfaction. God has given you peace." This is the day which God has made holy. They all wept. There is not anything mentioned why they wept, but there was definitely something which made them cry. Maybe they were able to see their own sin and wrongdoings in the light of the Word of God when it was read. The Word of God invites us to listen. When we listen the Word of God, we are able to listen the words of the living God. It is the Spirit that connects us with the scriptures written in different parts of the world by different people, but speaks on behalf of the same God, the creator of heavens and the earth. The Bible is thousands of years old. How could it be relevant now in the 21st century? That is a question which we are going to discuss briefly today. In 1864, some former slave in Maryland presented Abraham Lincoln with a gift of the Bible. According to one report, Lincoln replied, "In regard to this great book, I have but to say, it is the best gift God gave to humans. All the good the Savior gave to the world was communicated through this book." Is the Bible relevant? Apparently, Abraham Lincoln thought it was in his time, in the mid-19th century, but it is still today. But how it is relevant with us today? Is the Bible still a source of useful and reliable guidance in the modern world, or is it locked in the past? Does the Bible contain realistic assessments of our challenges and offers successful solutions? The Bible preserves a storehouse of wisdom and explains timeless questions. Why do bad things happen to good people? Where does evil come from? What is the meaning of life? Instead of giving straight answers to these questions, the Bible gives us the way of thinking about these issues more profoundly. The book of Proverbs, on the other hand, is full of straight practical wisdom. Proverbs contains advice as relevant today as it was 3,000 years ago. Perhaps you heard your parents or grandparents saying, "Early to bed, early to rise, make a man healthy, wealthy, and wise." Well, nearly 3 millenniums ago, an ancient biblical proverb conveyed a similar message, emphasizing the value of discipline and hard work. The Bible is brutally honest about how deeply people are broken and flawed. It reflects on the pain and loneliness of broken hearts and lost friendship. But it does not leave us alone in our hurt. It sets before the guidance for the way back with promises of reconciliation and wholeness that people desire. Any honest assessment of scriptures reveals that forgiveness is at its core. Not just forgiveness from God, but forgiveness of others. When we receive and give forgiveness, we are able to make our life beautiful. Bible gives us all realistic perspectives to adopt in our lives. Perhaps unexpectedly, the Bible presents a realistic and balanced approach to the challenges of life. The Old Testament book of Ecclesiastes remains one of the most relevant documents from the ancient world. In it, the teacher addresses issues such as education, vocation, laziness, patriotism, and aging, and importance of living a godly life from youth. Through knowing God, he ultimately finds meaning in life. Before that, his life was meaningless. Bible provides us psychological supports by telling us the story of those people who were not perfect. They had various issues, like many of us today are struggling with the issues that we face. And because of coronavirus situation, we talk about a lot about psychological support and mental health issues and so on. We read in the Bible, there were various men and women who find purpose in life. in spirit or being uncertain, ruthless or selfish. The powerful and powerless, rich and poor, pious and different sort of people found their contentment, courage and confidence through God. In the Bible, we read stories. Our murderer becomes a leader, a prostitute, the ancestor of a spiritual hero, a dishonest tax collector, a benefactor, a shy guy, an instructor, and a religious zealot, an ambassador of faith. Barren women become mother of important children. Cowardly fishermen become a spokesman for Reformation. People with impediments become messenger for God. The encouragement that Bible gives us is great. After all, we are imperfect, and how God has used the weak, the poor, and the people under social, psychological, and economical pressure. This is a great message and hope that the Bible gives us. The Bible, the Word of God, is not changed, but it changes lives. When we read it, we know what it is. Dear brothers and sisters, we just need to thank God for this gift of God, the greatest gift ever God gave to humans for their guidance. The Word of God. In Wales, we know the story of Mary Jones, a simple story that helped the British leaders to establish the first ever Bible society. We have time to listen what is going on in the world through various TV channels, but we sometimes don't have time to read the Bible. But when we read the Bible, we know not only what is happening, but why it is happening, and what is the solution to make this world a peaceful place for ourselves and for our next generations.
Let us affirm our faith together. I believe and trust in God the Father, who created all that is. I believe and trust in his Son, Jesus Christ, who redeemed mankind. I believe and trust in his Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God. I believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, and forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, help us also to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and forever hold fast to the hope of eternal life, which you have given us in our Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, the author of peace and lover of unity, to know you is eternal life, to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your servants, from all assaults of our enemies, that we may trust in your defence and not fear the power of any adversary. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God and Father, you have created us by your power and redeemed us by your love. Guide and strengthen us by your Spirit, that we may give ourselves in love and service to you and to one another, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our intercessions today come from the prayer ministry of the Coromila community in Northern Ireland. God of prudent precautions, of corrective adjustments. In community, we make decisions based not on personal convenience nor private preference, but what is best for the whole. As we pull back from a desired outcome and let reality have its say, give us the grace to accept what is right for the many, so that life is more than survival, but a harvest that continually thrives. God of chaos and fear, God of the day we create, the eternal nature of your love is something much greater than permanence. We don't so much rest upon it because it is fixed and unchanging, as we continually discover it's surprising and true. Morning by morning, new mercies we see. Give us faith, not in what we hope will last from the first breath of creation, but in what arrives. In this newborn moment, your voice bringing light with news that is good. Amen. Our second hymn is a great favourite of many, Shine, Jesus, Shine. Thank you.
Spirit of Truth lead you into all truth. Give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and strengthen you to proclaim the word and works of God. And the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.